students, let's go on to learn the functions of some more modal auxiliaries. We have already seen can, could, may, might. Now let's go on with the next ones. So the next one in modal auxiliaries will be will. Okay, he will go to the market tomorrow. Students, simple. Here it just expresses the future tense. Okay, so will is used to express the future tense. Next, will you help me with my homework? Again, it sounds like a polite request. We've already seen polite request earlier, that is could. And now here we see will also can be used as polite request. Next, I will not listen to what he says. Very clear, this is determination. Or sometimes willingness. When I say I will do this, then it is willingness. Okay, so will is used to express determination or willingness here. So basically, the three functions of will are future tense, polite request, determination, and willingness. Next one, would. He would go to the gym every evening. He would go. That means this shows a habitual action in the past. Now if I say, would you lend me something? Again, it sounds like a polite request. So another function of would is polite request. One more mood can we see here. Otto would probably shake my hand. Very clearly, this is a possibility. It may happen. So Otto would probably shake my hand. Possibility. She told him that she would become his letter daughter. Students told him that. Once again, what do you understand by that? That it is indirect speech. So when we change a sentence from direct to indirect speech, the will in the direct speech changes to would in indirect. Let's take this with an example. She said to him, I will become your letter daughter. When you change it to indirect, it will become, she told him that she would become his letter daughter. So will changes to would. And therefore, what is the function here? Past tense of will, that is an indirect speech. Once again, let's enlist the functions of would. Habitual action in the past, polite request, possibility, past tense of will. Okay, let's go on to the next one. Shall. They shall be punished for their wrongdoing. This sounds like a threat, so it is used to express threat. Next, you shall not go to the gym every evening. This is telling somebody not to do something, so it expresses prohibition, to prohibit, to stop someone from doing something. Next one, shall we go for a picnic this weekend, students? Oh, shall expresses suggestion. So what are the three things that are expressed by the word shall? So the functions or the moods expressed by shall are threat, prohibition, and suggestion. Let's go on to the next one, that is should. You should help the poor. Students, here should shows a sense of duty. So should is used to express obligation, and obligation means one's own duty. Now let's see another one. You should practice regularly. This is not a duty, this is a suggestion. So here should is used to express suggestion. Next, we can see that the functions of should are obligation or suggestion. So we have seen shall, should, we have seen will, would. Let's go on to the next one, must. Let's see the sentences. We must respect all religions. Again, it's a sense of duty. So here it is an obligation. And she must have forgotten the keys. So you're trying to guess. So here must expresses conjecture or guess. Conjecture meaning guess. Okay, students, you must reach the office in time. Here it is a compulsion. So the functions expressed by must are obligation, conjecture or guess, and compulsion. Next, we shall see ought to. Now, you ought to look after our old parents. Here, students, ought to again is a sense of duty. It's a moral obligation. So moral obligations means moral duty, and therefore it expresses moral obligation. They ought to win the game today. Ought to, again here, students, it means probability. Now, what do we mean by probability? It is a stronger possibility based on certain situations. Let's take a situation. If a student is very serious, or rather very studious, and has been getting first rank every time, then it is probable that he will get a first rank in the next test. So it is based on certain situations, you are predicting something. So we say he ought to get a first rank. So students, what are the functions of ought to? Moral obligation and probability. Next one, used to. They used to play cricket every evening. Now used to expresses habitual action in the past. Remember we said even would? So you have one more year habitual action in the past. Then there used to be a hotel at the corner of the street. Earlier there used to be a hotel, now there isn't. So it shows existence of something in the past. So what are the functions of used to? Habitual action in the past and existence of something in the past. Next, we go on to the next one, that is need. Students, he need not pay the money right away. Need not. It is a negation. Okay, it is a negative sentence. Here it expresses absence of necessity. If I say, need he pay the money right away? It's a question, it's an interrogation. And again, it shows necessity in the form of a question. So students, we note here that the functions of need are necessity, but very important, need is used as a modal auxiliary only in the negative or interrogative form. That means in the affirmative form, it is not a modal auxiliary. Please make a note of that. Next one, dare. How dare you touch my bag? So here it expresses courage. How did you have the courage to touch my bag? And then you dare not contradict me. So here you are challenging something. So what are the two functions of dare? It is either courage or expressing challenge. Once again, you can notice that dare is used as a modal auxiliary only in negative or interrogative form, just like the previous one, that is need. Okay, so students, we have seen the functions of all the modal auxiliaries, the moods expressed by the modal auxiliaries, and we have something else in store in the next module. See you there.